Amplifier wattage and speaker impedance matching can be a tricky and technical process, even for the most seasoned audiophile. Many of our customers often have countless queries about this important process. In this video, we guide you on how to select an amp or receiver to match the impedance and power needs of your speakers without getting too technical. Before we get into it, please subscribe to our channel. Also, hit the bell icon to get notified every time we post a new video. Now, let's dig in. Deciding on a set of speakers and a receiver requires you to understand the two most important measurement parameters, which are power handling and output, that is measured in watts, and impedance, that is measured in ohms. First, let's look at impedance. Simply put, it is a measure of the electrical resistance of your components, which is measured in ohms and is represented by this Greek omega-like symbol. Most speakers and receivers have impedance ratings in increments of 2, 4, 6, and 8 ohms, listed in order of least to most importance. A rule of thumb to follow is that the lower the number of ohms, the harder the receiver will have to work to power or drive the speakers. You'll need to match the number of ohms between your receiver and speaker. This information is available in the receiver specifications and is usually listed by channel. Some manufacturers will also include their recommendations. If your receiver or amplifier is running with lower impedance such as 4 ohms, the speakers will receive more power. It works similar to roadways, where more cars can move through a highway with more lanes. If impedance level don't match, you may cause permanent damage to either your speakers or receiver. Now, let's look at power handling. The most advertised specification of any speaker or receiver is the power handling. This number is measured in watts and is usually denoted with a W along with terms such as RMS, peak, program, and continuous, etc. Simply put, it is the amount of power needed from the receiver or an amplifier to drive the speakers and reproduce sound without audible distortion. It is important to confirm if a manufacturer lists the peak power or RMS or the average power output. While most home theater speaker manufacturers mention the exact wattage and impedance, a few mention power handling as a range such as 100 to 200 watts. You may also come across terms such as recommended or required power amplification in some speakers' technical specifications. For example, if you have a 6 ohm speaker with a power handling range between 100 to 150 watts, you will need a receiver or amplifier with a rated power of at least 100 watts RMS going up to 150 watts. An amplifier with less than 100 watts can still power the speakers, but you may hear distortion at high volumes. It may also lead to damage to the amplifier or speakers. It is recommended that the amplifier should provide 10% more power than the speakers are rated for. This is done to compensate for or to have headroom for power spikes that occur in fluctuating dynamic ranges, for example in movie scenes with loud noises like explosions or gunfires, or in music parts with orchestras or drums, etc. Be careful not to overpower or overdrive too. That is a sure way to blow up speaker drivers, especially the tweeters. Finally, our general advice would be that it is fine to connect speakers with a higher impedance to an amplifier capable of operating with a lower impedance. However, do not connect speakers with lower impedance, say 4 ohms, to an amplifier with a higher minimum impedance, say 8 ohms for example. Another important factor in this process is the speaker sensitivity, which is a measure of how efficiently it creates volume from the power it draws. Understanding speaker sensitivity requires some basic technical knowledge and calculations. We'll cover that in one of our future videos. So, be sure to follow and subscribe to our channel. If you still have doubts, feel free to get in touch with our experienced, knowledgeable, and helpful team. We will answer all your queries and help you design your dream home theater in India, that too within your budget. If you like this video, don't forget to hit the like button. Also, subscribe to our channel and follow us on social media for more such interesting and informational videos. Thank you for watching.